Okay. And now coming to this one. So you're just, they're going to ask you. So in every interview, definitely they're going to ask you, tell about yourself. So whatever that you have prepared, given in your resume, same is you need to talk about in your introduction. Okay, tell about yourself. You have already given in the form of hard copy, that is your resume. Resume is going to talk about yourself. Again, interviewer do not want to go ahead with everything, but he wanted to listen from you. What are you? Okay, so while you are talking about yourself, you can just go through your resume. What you have mentioned in your resume, the same you need to mention here, nothing more than that. Okay, so these two are copy paste. Tell about yourself and your resume is copy paste. Okay, so now look at here. So first, what you need to talk about, and you are going to apply it for as an experienced resource, you're going to apply for a job. Now you have to introduce yourself. You're not required to say your name if your interviewer has already called you with your name. Okay, so Naresh, tell you about yourself. You're not required to again introduce myself, Naresh. That is not required at all. Okay, because he knows what is your name already. Okay, so without that, suppose if it is a telephonic interview or something, suppose they are not going to mention your name, then you can introduce saying your name. Okay, that is good. If you have already introduced with your name before this question is being asked, or if interviewer is going to call you with the name, already looking at your resume by your name, then you are not required to say what is your name. Okay, so then you have to start telling about yourself. So mainly when you are attending and you're applying for a job as an experienced resource, and tell about yourself, you remember, you should start with your professional skills, professional experience only. This is most important. If you're applying as an experienced resource, they always bother about your professional experience. You should start like you're a professional IT employee, okay, with total how many years of experience? 7 years of experience, out of which the relevant experience on the technology Pega has 4 years, and remaining 3 years I have worked on 2 years Java and 1 year of testing. This order should be same as the order. So if you read it from back to starting, okay, it should say like you have joined IT industry, 1 year you have worked on testing, later you have jumped on to Java, later you have jumped on to Pega. This is how. If you look at your resume, the same you have mentioned on your resume, top of your resume mentioning your professional experience. Same we are saying here also. So it should be like same what is there in your resume, okay? And then talk about your current organization, current company that you are working with. So what is the current organization that you are? So currently I am working with so and so organization since past 4 years, and before that I have worked with, let's say, Wipro organization for 2 years, and before that I have worked with Infosys for 1 year. Like this, you have to always start from what are you currently and then go back. Okay, so this is what the organizations that you have worked on, clearly you have given information. And next you talk about the domain knowledge. So I have experience working with these domains. What are the domains I have worked on? So you should understand the difference between domain and technology. Okay, domain is always, domain is going to talk about your sector of business where you have worked on. So insurance is a domain. In an insurance domain, we can have a number of technologies being used. Okay, so the domain experience that you're going to talk about, so you cannot say Pega is a domain, testing, many people will say testing domain I'm working with, and many people Java domain I'm working on. This is wrong. This is not domain. Your domain is insurance domain. Insurance is a domain. Banking is a domain. So what domains that you have knowledge on, experience on? You have worked with, I have worked with insurance domain. Currently I'm working with the insurance domain. Before that I have worked on banking domain, and initially I have started working with healthcare domain. So like this, you can just go ahead and mention your the domains what you have worked on. And after the domains, you just mention the technology. So currently I am working with Pega technology, again in insurance domain. Okay, and apart from this, I have Java and testing experience also. Testing can be a tool, it's not a technology, it can be a tool. So now after that, you just talk about the roles and responsibilities. Generally people will say first project and then roles and responsibilities. So recommended approach that what I want to tell you is, first you talk about what are the roles and responsibilities that you are playing in your current project. So you're working in so-and-so domain on so-and-so technology with client. You just mentioned with client. So XYZ client. It can be, let's say, Humana is the client that I'm working with. Okay. And here I'm playing these roles with this client and current project. I'm playing the roles and response. And you can also mention the project name if you wanted to mention. Okay. Project name. And the roles and responsibilities you need to talk about now. And this one I forgot to tell you in resume preparation, right? In your resume preparation, you have to write roles and responsibilities also. For every project, you have to add roles and responsibilities during your resume preparation. So let me talk about roles and responsibilities now. So the roles and responsibilities, what you are mentioning in your resume, same you have to tell now. Okay. So these are the roles and responsibilities that you have to mention for every project. So many of the resources, they are mentioning roles and responsibilities as the technical aspects. Suppose you consider Pega, take Pega. So in the roles and responsibilities, people are mentioning like work done activities, work done data transforms, work done integration rules. Like this, they are mentioning. Suppose you take Java, created classes, used variables, and worked on inheritance, worked on circumstances. Like this, they are other things. They're mentioning in Java. So this is not roles and responsibilities. These are technical aspects what you have hands on as an experienced resource. Roles and responsibilities should always be related to, in the project, what daily activities that you are performing. Your roles and responsibilities should be like this. As a developer, you are working on business use case requirements. You're working on business use case requirements. I have already sent you this in a resume, sorry, in an email, I believe. Just hang on 1 minute. Roles and responsibilities. Here you go. I've already told you, just go through it. So working with business use case requirements, this is one thing that you're going to do, where you are going to understand, analysis, and do the implementation of your business requirements. And involved in daily status and stand-up calls. So you're going to involve in everyday regular status calls. This is one of the role that you are playing. This is your responsibility that you have to join the call every day to give updates about your work, what you have completed today. And involved in internal team meetings. So internal team meetings also you're going to involve in. So apart from your regular daily status calls, you are also going to join team meetings where you're going to discuss internally, where there is no business intervention. So business people are not going to join in this. Only your internal teams are going to join. What we have done so far, what we have to complete. All these discussions will be there, and preparing minutes of meeting documents and following up on the action items which have to be completed. This is also one of your roles and role and responsibility. And here you go, work with onshore and offshore team model. So you have offshore team as well as onshore team. You have that experience working, coordinating with both of these teams from onshore and offshore is also one of your role. And doing functional peer reviews. Functionality wise, someone else has developed something, that functionality you're going to review as a colleague. So this can be your task, because your team lead is going to ask you, he has done this use case requirement, just peer test it once functionally whether it is working fine or not. So you might be involved in this task. And involved in defect fixing, some your development, whatever that is being deployed into QA region, next level of sub regions, if at all QA teams are going to find out any defects, they will raise defects in defect management tool and they're going to assign you. You're going to take that task and work on defect fixing, and sometimes if at all any production issues, you will also work on bug fixes and using the tools like Jira. This is also one of your role. Apart from development, you're playing a role of working on defects fixing and all. That is your responsibility. And involved in deployments in lower environment, generally in production environments, deployments will be done by release management teams. So your development environment to QA, it can be done by developers in some of the organizations. Some of the organizations, it will not be done, but it is okay if you mention like you are involved in deployments in the lower environment from development to QA, up to that only, if you are aware of the deployment process. And preparation of implementation plans and production deployment tasks, following up on that for the approvals and all from different managers. So like this, you are going to involve in preparing the document every time when your production deployment is there. As a developer, you prepare the document and send it for the approvals to your manager, business analyst manager, as well as your scrum masters from all those operators or let's say actors, you are going to take the approval from. And supporting for production deployment with release management teams. So In production, you will not do the deployments. You will just go and sit along with the release management team. If at all they are facing any technical issues, you may have to support with respect to your development what you have done. So like this, your production, your roles and responsibilities, you should always talk about what activities that you are doing day to day in your current project. Okay. Apart from this, if you wanted to mention the roles and responsibilities before projects what you have worked on, that is also good, but it is not required actually. On the current project, what are the roles and responsibilities? Before you have worked as a testing engineer, you're not required to mention those roles and responsibilities now because you are not applying on the test. Okay, if they ask you, again, you have to mention that. Otherwise, it is not required at all. Okay. So this is about roles and responsibilities that you have to mention. Okay. So once you, so it will not take more than 30 to 45 seconds to talk about all these points. Okay, and next one. After your roles and responsibilities is completed, you can just go ahead and say about the current project. When you talk about current project, remember one thing, your project explanation should be proceeded like this. So now let's go ahead and talk about the third section, how to explain your project. So when you are going to explain about your project, remember one thing, your whatever the project that you are mentioning in your resume, the latest project, the same you have to start explain until and unless interviewer is going to ask you explain about your previous project. Some interviewers will ask you leaving your current project, they will ask you explain about your previous project. So your preparation should proceed with all the projects what you are mentioning. Any project that you are mentioning in your resume, if they ask you to explain, you should be able to explain. Do not think like the previous project interviewers are not going to ask me, only they will ask me current project always. So do not just prepare only with current project and appear for the interview. That is not recommended. So you just prepare for all the projects what you have mentioned in your resume. You should have idea about functional processing as well as technical aspects, both. Okay. So when remember another thing, like when you are going to explain about your project, you take maximum of 5 minutes, not more than that. Interviewers, even they will not be interested to listen to you if you are extending it for 10 minutes and 15 minutes. Okay, maximum wind up your project 3 to 5 minutes. 5 minutes means we can talk a lot actually. Okay, 3 minutes is fair enough. 3 to 5 minutes is okay in between. Okay, that is fair enough. And you remember the most importantly, when you are explaining project, first 30 seconds what you are going to explain. Within first 30 seconds itself, interviewer should get complete idea about your project. That is how you have to explain. After you complete first 30 seconds, he should understand completely what is your project all about. And the elaboration of what you have told for this 30 seconds, the elaboration should happen next to 2.5 minutes or 3 minutes or 4 minutes. That means, suppose if you are explaining about, let's say for example, a banking project. Let's take e-commerce project for example, first one. Amazon application, for example, you are working. So my application is intended to, my application is a purchase center application where users can buy a product and they can make payments. An invoice will be generated and an email will be sent to the buyer, whoever is going to buy the product, a confirmation email will be sent. Now he is clearly understand your complete project. Okay, your project is all about, it is a purchase center application where users are going to select the products, add to cart and purchase and then make the payment. All this you are not required to mention. Make it very simple. This is what, so my application is a purchase center application, online e-commerce platform where users are going to buy a product and make the payments, invoice will be generated and email confirmation will be sent to them about the purchase. That's it. Similarly, if you are going to talk about a banking project, let's say your project is about creating bank accounts. Okay, my application is all about processing bank accounts. Any user is going to request for a new account. This application is going to create a case for new account creation, collect all user details and process, and account number will be generated and it will be activated. That's it, done. First 30 seconds, this is how you have to summarize overall project. Suppose if it is insurance, this application is mainly meant for insurance policy processing. It will collect all the details from the customers, generate insurance policies with for a term of 1 year or 3 years or 5 years with effect to an expiry dates. Completed. Okay. If your application is court orders processing, that means a government related processing, for example, any application you take, suppose if it is government, suppose where, when there is any dispute, let's say dispute management, credit card application is yours. Whenever there is any fraudulent transaction is being identified by a customer, customer is going to report to customer care, and from there onwards case will be created and it will be investigated. This is the process. So you have to start and summarize overall in first 30 seconds. My application is a dispute management application. When any fraud transaction is being identified, customers are going to call the customer care. A case will be created. It will be just verified. Case will be verified and accordingly action will be taken on this. Okay. So this is how you just summarize, give all information about your complete transaction processing within first 30 seconds. After first 30 seconds is completed, your interviewer should get a clear idea about what you're going to say next. Okay, that means you are going to elaborate this now. You have given a summary of what is your project all about, and now you have to start elaborating. So generally, what is the mistake that people will do is, suppose, let's take for example, e-commerce website. Okay, you have worked on e-commerce application. They will start like this. I am working on an e-commerce application. The first screen of my application is where products will be displayed. So users are going to log in, products will be displayed. In the products, they are going to choose one of the product and they will add to cart. So here the process is like, after they add to cart, they can go ahead and buy it, or they can delete from the cart. So, or they can, so when they choose to buy, it will be added further in the next process, collecting further details from the customer. So during this process, user can cancel the transaction or they can proceed forward. So like this, if you're going to start elaboration from the beginning itself, he's not going to come. So because it is e-commerce, everything is there in mind. Okay, but other projects, other business projects, interviewer will not come to know about everything in the project. So if you start talking about the project from screen one to screen N and complete process, and if this is the way that you're going to take explain your project, interviewer is going to wait when this is going to be ending. So what is the exact ending? After you give the last point, then only he will come to know what is your project all about. Then he has to go ahead and in his mind, he has to go ahead and recollect all the points what you have told from the beginning. And finally, summarizing all this, he has to understand, okay, this is all project, this is so this is all about the application processing what you have worked on. So you should not give this kind of impression to the interviewer. You do not start explaining your project from beginning to ending, each step by step at the initial go. So you have to take it at the second go. The first go should be a summary of your project. Okay, summary of your business completely. After he listened to you first 30 seconds, he should come to know with a clear idea. You should have a clear idea of what is your application all about. That's it. Later, if you do not elaborate also, it should be there in his mind. Okay, now, after first 30 seconds is completed, now you start explaining about your project in detail. So our application has a single sign-on where users are going to log in. It will be authenticated and authorized accordingly. Do not completely explain about web servers. That is not required. Until unless he is going to ask you about architecture of your application login process, no need to talk about it. Just simply tell, so we have authentication authorization process. Once it is completed, so the respective portals will be, user is going to land onto the respective portal where he can create a case from create menu, and a case gets created for insurance policy processing system. And now we are going to, in the first screen, we are going to collect the details about customer account. So that is, sorry, in the first screen, we are going to search for the existence of customer account based on customer's identification number, that is personal identification number, other address details maybe. So if customer is found, we are going to pull the existing customer data and start creating an insurance policy. Otherwise, we will create a new account. Okay, so you just talk about new account creation. Customer details will be collected. Account will be created. Account data is getting stored, so on so forth. And the next screen, policy creation starts. So during the creation of the policy, a code will be getting generated. So for this, we are going to collect customer's personal details, if it is vehicle related, vehicle details, and driver's details, primary driver, secondary driver, like this. If it is health insurance related, accordingly you mention health insurance related terms. Okay. And once all these details are collected, it will be sent for the review. So the next step is review in read-only format. It will be reviewed and sent back if any changes are required. Otherwise, review is successful. It will go to the next level of generating the quote amount. So this will be just given to the customer. Customer is agreeing with this. Okay, take the profile forward and then take it further and add different coverages, additional coverages and all, and send it for the approval. Approvals are done, policy will be generated, and customer is going to avail this policy from the effective date, and customer is going to make the payment using the payment gateway, something like this. Okay, so this is what you have to talk about elaboratively, each screen by screen. So before you just go ahead and appear for interview, whatever the project that you are going to choose, if you are already working on a project, that is well and good. If you are not working on any project and you are mentioning a project saying that you have worked on so and so project, for example, you have learned a different technology, you are working on so and so technology, you have learned a completely different technology, and you wanted to mention a project. So generally what we do here is we check with our friends, our family members or someone, and those who are working on the same technologies and all, and we get the projects from them and mention the same in your resume and get the explanation from them, and the same explanation you are going to give in your interview. During this point of time, if interviewer is going to cross question you going in depth into the project, definitely it is damn sure that you will not be able to explain him, because you have gained the knowledge from someone else. It's not your self experience. So you will not have such confidence at all. On the project and all, you will not have complete grip. So to avoid all this, the practice is like this. See, you remember always your business applications, whatever the projects that you are going to mention in your resume, are real-time applications. Real-time applications means general business users or general citizens of country. Those people are going to access the application for your real-life transactional processing. Whatever we do in our real life, all the tasks are being transformed into an application. Now application is going to do all these tasks. Previously, suppose, for example, if you take insurance policy processing system, when there is no computer knowledge and all, there are no computer software applications and all, all is manual process. An agent is going to collect all the documents. After that, he is going to go to insurance departments and insurance branches. He will submit there. They will manually review all the documents. Based on the data, there will be a person called rater. Based on the data submitted, the rater is going to perform the calculations manually. For this rating itself, to process applications rating and all, it will take around 1 month or 2 months. There are days they will do it for 3 months or 4 months also previously, because all it is manual process. Now the same manual process what you are doing is being transformed into a business application by applying the technology. Now application is doing this. So for this kind of parameters, this is the rating calculation. You have written a program and computer set. For this kind of data, this is the rating calculation. Conditional basic multiple rating calculations are there now. So all the process of reviewing everything is being done now by application itself. Automation reviews are there and everything is available now. So whatever that happens in your real life, which we do manually, now it is being done by software application. That is what real-time application means. The application tasks what were being performed in your real life before software is a real-time application of that set, which has been applied with technology, nothing more than that. Real-time application, as you are thinking, it's not complex as you're thinking. It is very simple. What manual tasks we do will be done in an application by applying technology. That is what the meaning of real-time application. So you take a bank account creation. Previously it was like this. The person should go into bank and submit the document to another person. So these documents, everything should be manually reviewed. They have to maintain a lot of records. And finally, your accounts will be generated. Account numbers and everything also have to be maintained in manual records only. There is no software at all. Same process what we used to do manually, now just changed into an application. That is what? A software application, which is a real-time project. That's it. So now, as you have the capability to think and understand many different businesses in the real world, so any business which you feel you are comfortable with understanding step by step process. Suppose you take banking account creation, you are aware of all the process, right? Most of the things you are aware of. What are the processes? You submit the documents. That is what in the application you collect the documents and then send it for the review and do the data entry for each and every form, and it will be sent for the verifications, and there should be an attestation from the other customers. Someone should introduce you, something like this. And after approvals are been done, activation process will be done in a batch cycle. So everything step by step, you have to write down your project, what you want to mention in your resume. You should not ask someone else. you think of any business, take multiple sectors, banking, e-commerce, and take what is that, insurance sector, and you just go out and take, other than this, loan processing, financial domain, loans processing, or telecommunication domain, or logistics maintenance, or HR onboarding portals. Any business that is of your wish, it is not mandatory that this business should be available in the organization what you are mentioning, okay? But most important thing here is, instead of whether this application, this technology is there in the organization what you are mentioning, most important thing is whether you are aware of the project completely or not. Functionally as well as technology, anyway you are going to learn, you are going to apply the same technology in for the functional requirements implementation. So functionally you should know completely about the project. It should be there completely in your imagination, each step by step from beginning to ending. This is how you need to think about your project. So you are not required to ask someone else that what project is running there, can you explain me project and all. You just sit, take a notebook, and you choose one of the business, okay, loan processing. So you just start drawing about each screen by screen. In your notes, you draw screen one, these are the fields. Screen two, you just mention maximum 7 screens, that is fair enough. These are the fields, screen three, screen four, account creation process will be there. After account creation, loan processing. So you have divided into two different parts. Once account is created with customer basic data, collecting this basic details, loan account will be processed. Okay, in the loan account, what is the type of the loan, transaction details, what type of loan you want, how many years that you wanted to choose the tenure and all, and all this information. And next, review. Next screen is review screen. Next screen is verification screen. Next is approval screen. Like this, payment screen. Like this, you just go ahead and design your application screen by screen, draw it in your notes. Okay. And after this is completed, you will have a clear idea about what is the process. This is happy path. You also should have to think about knockout path. Knockout path means your profile can be rejected for some reasons, right? So take two or three parameters which you can imagine. In any business, apart from happy path of processing, there will be some knockout process. Okay, your application will not always be accepted. Any application, there can be reject situations. You think about any one of the reject situation and write down the reject flow. In the reject flow, for these parameters, profile is rejected, an email will be sent notifying the customer either to resubmit the same or completely or been rejected. You have not at all met the criteria. You reapply again for a new loan with other details or something like that. Okay, if you want new loan, you have to apply for below level of amount. Okay, that you can go ahead and reapply, or we can reinitiate reducing in the loan amount which you have requested. If you say yes, we'll proceed forward. Otherwise, we'll close the case saying it is completed. Some status. Okay, it is completed, rejected, or something like that. Okay. So just imagine what is the business that you, business application, what you are mentioning in your resume, same everything screen by screen should be there in your mind. And after this is completed, you just talk about technical aspects. Okay, you mention only functionally you explain the project, that is fair enough. Technically, you don't explain at all in the project explanation. That is not required until unless the interviewer is going to ask you. Functionally, you give overview within 30 seconds. And mention about the project screen by screen next two and a half minutes or 3 minutes. That is fair enough, and stop it and tell them that you are done with this. During your tell about yourself after your project explanation is completed, during your tell about yourself, you are not required to mention about your education details. That is not required. That is there in your resume. No need to mention about education details. You just mention about yourself. That is, what is your total IT experience and relevant IT experience, and what are the domains that you are working with, what is the current project and the client name, and you just mention about your roles and responsibilities, and then you talk about your project. That is, when you talk about your project in the project explanation, first 30 seconds overall overview of the project, you should have clear idea about what is your project, and then remaining time you have to go ahead and mention about screen by screen what is there in your application functionally. If interviewer is going to ask you technically, then you have to explain. In the first screen, we have used it technically. These are the activities, UI roles, and technical aspects you have to mention then only. Otherwise, it is not required. Because technology is different from each other, whatever the technology that you are working on, and just go ahead and accordingly apply the technology for what you have mentioned functionally, apply the technology and explain it. Generally, people, 90% of the interviewers are not going to ask about technical aspects. Okay, so everyone will think about functional as of now. Technically, they'll ask you technical questions in the interview. So after your project explanation is completed, that's it, done, fair enough. Okay, you can just go ahead and say, okay, I'm done with explaining myself, about myself. Okay, then he is going to ask you technical questions. So this is how, and methodology, if you wanted to mention also, you can mention. Before your roles and responsibilities, you can mention about your methodologies. Okay, that is also fair enough. Okay, everyone clear about this? So now, technically, if you want to explain, for suppose, if he's going to ask you, where you have used services, web services. So while you are designing your project, you just think about what are the different places where I can use web services in my application. Like what we have implemented here in our application, the same you can mention there also. Okay, now suppose when you are collecting the address details of a customer, okay, what are the address details? PIN code you will collect, right? So PIN code cannot be validated simply at your end. PIN code is known to only government. Whether it is valid PIN code or not, only government can say. Your banking application or insurance application cannot say that your PIN code is there. So whenever user enters a PIN code, based on PIN code, suppose you are going to locate the city or respective area, for example, then the PIN code here, it should be a service call. We have made a SOAP service call here and we have sent PIN code to some third party vendor, government department. So they have replied with the area details and all. So if PIN code is not identified, they enter a wrong PIN code, it says PIN code is wrong. Like this, this is one of the places where you have, you're verifying. And you are searching for a customer account, right? Suppose any product, anytime you are creating an account, it is going to, while you are creating account or before you are creating account, you can have a separate search screen. Suppose if you are creating an Amazon account, you enter the details and try to create, it will say customer already existing with this email address and phone number. Means there is a search internally happening. So account data, are you maintaining in the current PRPC system or third party systems? You can say we are initiating account creation process in PRPC and sending this data as a service call to someone else where we are maintaining all the accounts, because maintaining all accounts in one server will be a button. Okay, so your account search and account creation is also a service call where you are storing the data somewhere else. When searching, you are retrieving the data from some other third party system. It is also a service call. Like this, you need to identify all different places in your application where you are making service calls. Let's say policy number is being generated by Pega or some third party system. You can say third party system is generating. Here we are making a REST service call where we are sending all the data related to policy what is being submitted. And once the respective data is being sent, third party system is maintaining all the policy numbers where it is based on the details that are being submitted, it is going to generate a unique policy number and send us. We are storing the information here with the account number, but actual policy data will be available at the third party. Okay, so like this, you have to imagine about what are all the places where you can mention your web services, what are the places where you can mention some other technical aspects. This is how we have implemented this one. All this you have to design by yourself only. If you are going to learn this from someone else, the problem will be you can never clear your interview. That will not be possible at all, because you will not have such confidence. If you design by yourself everything, you will gain a lot of confidence internally. So because everything is known to you that you have designed, you can be confident enough while explaining. And if they are going to cross question also, the same way how you had process your thinking here, same way you will immediately go ahead and think about the things and immediately you're going to answer the interviewer. So your thought processing will be improved when you just go ahead and imagine your business like this and apply yourself designing everything, and technical application also you think about all the things by yourself. When you are going to do design a project like this by yourself, your thought processing will be improved. Any application you should be able to design like this, any application you should be able to mention on your resume and explain in an interview without any fear and doubt. This is clear, everyone? So this is how, now if you're going to mention, prepare your resume to keep the projects. Model resumes are to give you just an idea. Okay, do not copy as it is. You think of your own business which you are aware of. Any business it can be. Okay, it can be any business. And then start taking one of the business process and design like this and keep it in your resume. Okay, no matter whether it is there in the same organization what you are mentioning or not, no matter at all. Okay, but it is most important that you are aware of project completely, your application functionally and technically also. That is most important. If you are confident with these two things, that is fair enough, you should be able to crack the interview for sure. So everyone clear about this? Okay, so this is how you have to go ahead and explain your project. So before you start attending interviews, that is before you start preparing, while you are preparing your resume, you should be ready with all these things. You should have to prepare for completely, tell about yourself what you have to talk about, and project, what is completely project all about, functionally, technically, everything. You just be ready with, then only you start posting your resume. Without doing this, do not post your resumes. Okay, and I'm sure 99% of people, without designing all this itself, they will just go ahead and copy any other resumes and post it. It is not a good practice at all. You be ready yourself first and then post your resume. There is no hurry. Openings will be there forever. Jobs will be there forever. It's only thing that is required is you should have knowledge, enough knowledge. You should be confident enough to grab the interview. This is clear.